I think, nutrition in and of itself is something that requires a lot more study. It's only relatively recently in our history that we've taken a look at the foods we eat and deconstruct them for what's inside and identify how those things work in the body. And with obesity, you have kind of two sets of issues. You have the composition of the diet, in other words, how much of your diet is from protein, from fat, from carbohydrates, and also how much are you consuming. So a human can come obese basically by overconsuming calories from any source, whether it's from fat, carbohydrate, alcohol. If it has calories, it can accumulate in the body if you do not expend what you ingest. So the work that centers around nutrition and obesity, especially in relation to cancer, is, are there particular dietary components that lead to increased risk for cancer? Or is it overconsumption of a wide variety of different dietary constituents? And the answer is pretty complex. There isn't a simple answer to that. Although we do know, for instance, that there are nutritional deficiencies that can impede the body's own defenses to repair damaged cells or destroy damaged cells. And I think that's something that always brought me a lot of interest in cancer because I thought it was pretty amazing that all humans don't have cancer. You have millions and hundreds of millions of cell divisions every day, and the fact that errors in that division are repaired so efficiently is amazing because all it takes is one cell to grow out of control. And for, and every type of cell in the body, you have a different type of cancer. So it's pretty remarkable to me that we have built-in mechanisms via enzymes and proteins that use vitamins and minerals as part of their structure in order to maintain our normal functioning cells and normal functioning tissue. So you look at diets that are associated with decreased risk for cancer. Usually those things are high in fruits and vegetables. So they're high in antioxidant structures, which should complement or provide a kind of parallel pathway of protection against oxidizing substances in the body, which are carcinogenic to some degree, depending on what they are. And you also have specific enzymes like glutathione peroxidase and superoxide dismutase. These are enzymes with really great names that exist in order to combat the errors that constantly occur in our body. And those are enzymes that function optimally when you have optimal nutrition.